Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. In this video, I'm explaining about miscellaneous exercise on chapter 9, sequences and series, question number 7, 8 and 9 solution. Question number 7, if f is a function satisfying f of x plus y is equal to f of x into f of y for all x, y belongs to n, n means here set of natural numbers, such that f of 1 is equal to 3 and sigma x is equal to 1 to n, f of x is equal to 120, find the value of n. In this question, they have given some values. One is f of x plus y is equal to f of x into f of y. Then f of 1 is equal to 3 and sigma x is equal to 1 to n, f of x is equal to 120. These three values are given in the question. See, this means here the x value ranges from 1 to n. You have to put different values of x here, that is f of 1, then f of 2, f of 3 up to n, that is f of n. The sigma indicates the sum of these values, that is f of 1 plus f of 2 plus f of 3 plus so on up to f of n, that is equal to 120. It is given in the question. Now here we need to find out the n value. So to find the n value, first of all here we need the value of f of 1, f of 2, f of 3, like that way. See, already they have given in the question the f of 1 value. So now let us find out the next values, like f of 2, f of 3. So to find out that, here first I am taking here x is equal to 2. This I can take because in the question itself they have given that the x value ranges from 1 to n. So first now I will take here x is equal to 2, so that we can write the function as f of 2. Now the 2 I can write as 1 plus 1, which is nothing but 2 only. So I am writing now f of 1 plus 1. See, now f of 1 plus 1 we have here, and here you know that f of x plus y is equal to f of x into f of y. This is given in the question. So now you can apply this to this particular value, so that we can write this one as f of 1 into f of 1. We know the value of f of 1, which is 3. Just put that value here, 3 into 3, that is equal to 9. Next here, let us take x is equal to 3. If I take here x is equal to 3, then we can write the function as f of 3, and this 3 we can write as 2 plus 1. Now we have here this value in this way, that is f of x plus y form. So now you can apply this one, so that we can write this value as f of 2 into f of 1. F of 2 value is 9, then f of 1 value is 3. 9 into 3 is equal to 27. Next, put x is equal to 4. So f of 4 is equal to, we can write this 4 as 3 plus 1, f of 3 plus 1. And this we can write by using this one as f of 3 into f of 1. We know the value of f of 3, which is 27. F of 1 value is 3. 27 into 3 is equal to 81. Next here, let us now write down this one by expanding sigma x is equal to 1 to n f of x. This means it is the sum of values, that is f of 1 plus f of 2 plus f of 3 plus f of 4 plus so on up to f of n, that is equal to 120. This is given in the question. Now here we know the value of f of 1, f of 2. Just put that value here. So this forms a series up to the last term value we don't know. So just write down here the last term as n term. That is equal to 120. Here we know the sum. Now here this forms a series, and this series is a geometric progression. See here, the first term is a is equal to 3, and the common ratio, if you find here between two continuous numbers, that is 9 divided by 3, that will give you 3. 27 divided by 9, that will give you 3. Or 81 divided by 27, that will give you 3. So this value, this series, is in the form of geometric progression. And also we know the value of sum, that is Sn is equal to 120. So now you can directly apply the geometric progression sum formula. Sn is equal to a into r to the power n minus 1 divided by r minus 1, where here r value is greater than 1. In this case also, R value is greater than 1, that is 3. So let us apply this formula here. Let us put all these values here. So Sn is 120, that is equal to A is 3, 3 into 3 to the power n minus 1 divided by 3 minus 1. So 120 is equal to 3 into 3 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2. Multiply this with this so that we have here 240 is equal to 3 into 3 to the power n minus 1. So this you can bring to this side so that we have here 3 to the power n minus 1 is equal to 240 divided by 3, that is equal to 80. So 3 to the power n is equal to this minus 1 we can take to this side, 80 plus 1. So 3 to the power n is equal to 81. This 81 we can write in terms of 3 to the power, that is 3 to the power 4 is nothing but 81. Now among these two values, you can see that here the base values are same. That means we can equalize the power values, so n is equal to 4. Question number 8. The sum of some terms of GP is 315, whose first term and the common ratio are 5 and 2 respectively. Find the last term and the number of terms. In this question, they have given the sum of some terms of geometric progression. So Sn is equal to 315. And also they have given the first term, that is A is equal to 5, and the common ratio, that is R, is equal to 2. And we need to find out the nth term, that is nothing but the last term and the number of terms. First here, as we know these values, let us use the formula to find the sum of n terms of geometric progression. That is Sn is equal to A into R to the power n minus 1 divided by R minus 1, where R value must be greater than 1. And here we have the R value is equal to 2. Now substitute these values in this formula. So we have here 315 is equal to 5 into 2 to the power n minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. That is equal to 315. That is 315 is equal to 5 into 2 to the power n minus 1. This 5 we can bring to this side. So we have here 315 divided by n, divided by 5 is equal to 2 to the power n minus 1. That is 2 to the power n minus 1 is equal to 63. 2 to the power n is equal to 63 plus 1. That is 2 to the power n is equal to 64. Now this 64 we can write in terms of power of 2. 2 to the power 6 is nothing but 64. Now here see, among these two terms the base values are same, so that we can equalize the power value, so n is equal to 6. Now here we got the number of terms. Next we need to find out the last term or the nth term. To find the nth term of geometric progression, we have the formula an is equal to a into r to the power n minus 1. In this formula, substitute the values. A is equal to 5, R is equal to 2. These values are given in the question, and N is equal to 6 value just now we got. So substitute these values. That is 5 into 2 to the power 6 minus 1. That is 5 into 2 to the power 5. That is 5 into 32. So the nth term or the last term is equal to 160. Question number 9. The first term of a GP is 1. The sum of the third term and the fifth term is 90. Find the common ratio of GP. See, in this question, they have given the first term, that is A is equal to 1. And also they have given that the sum of the third and the fifth term is 90. When we consider a geometric progression, in the geometric progression, we can take the terms like this way. AR, AR square, AR cube, AR to the power 4, AR to the power 5. Like this way, the last term is AR to the power n minus 1. These are the terms of geometric progression. Now, in the question, they have given that the sum of third term and the fifth term is 90. So, in this, here, the third term is 1, 2, 3. This is the third term and the fifth term is AR to the power 4. Now the sum of these two is given, so we can write here AR square plus AR to the power 4 is equal to 90. From this take A out so that we have here A into R square plus R to the power 4 is equal to 90. We know the value of A which is given, so put that value 1 into R square plus R to the power 4 is equal to 90. That is R to the power 4 plus R square, this 90 you can bring to this side, minus 90 is equal to 0. Now here we have to factorize this one. See, here we have minus 90 and here we have 1. So we have to find out such two numbers so that when we multiply two numbers, we have to get minus 90, and when we add the numbers, we have to get 1. Such two numbers are 10 and minus 9. See, 10 into minus 9 is equal to minus 90, and if we add these two numbers, 10 and minus 9, we get here 1. So just put these values in the place of r square. So we have here r to the power 4 plus 10r square minus 9r square. This will give you r square. Then when you multiply this one here, you are going to get the value, that is minus 90 r to the power 4. So now here you can take the common terms out, that is r square you can take out, so that we have here the remaining value r square plus 10. Then from this you can take minus 9 out, so that we have here r square. Then here minus sign is taken out, that means this becomes plus 10, then that is equal to 0. Now among these two, the common value is r square plus 10, take that out, so remaining term is r square minus 9, that is equal to 0. Then we have here r square plus 10 is equal to 0. That is r square is equal to minus 10. See, this is not possible. Whenever we find the square of any number, then you are going to get the positive value only. There is no chance that you may get negative value. So if we have this kind of value, that means this is imaginary. So that's why in this question, we are not going to consider this one. Instead of that, we will consider only this value. That is r square minus 9 is equal to 0. That is r square is equal to 9 and r is equal to plus or minus 3. So here we got the common ratio, that is r is equal to plus 3 or r is equal to minus 3. Thanks for watching.